All right, and I'm also going to, I want to welcome everybody to tracking students' activity in Blackboard. And everybody at this point should see my screen for the PowerPoint, okay? Can everybody see it at this point? I don't know if anybody can unmute for a second and just tell me you can see my PowerPoint.
Yeah. Yes.
Okay, perfect. All right. Okay, with everything going on with the students and with faculty trying to get used to using Blackboard, one of the biggest questions that I get at different times is how can I check to see if my students are active in my course? So I'm going to show you a bunch of tools today that you can use. Some are very simple, some are a little bit more where you have to run reports to be able to see them. But as you know, this is going to be recorded, and we're going to put it out there for everybody to have, and we do have it on the blog. All right. And if you want to email us, you can email us through onlinelearning@niagaracc.suny.edu. And then this is our blog here. I also put the link to the blog in the chat area of the presentation. Okay. So if you want to grab that, you can. All right. Now, one of the biggest things is what can we track for students in Blackboard, okay? One thing that we can find out is when they last accessed the course that you were in, okay? We can look to see what they've submitted, and then we can see what things or what items that they've clicked on, whether it be a file or a page or a test or anything like that inside your course. And the biggest thing is, the default is that it's not going to keep track of students' clicks with inside the content of your course. So one of the biggest things that you want to make sure you do is every piece of information you create in your course, whether it be a page or a test or whatever it is, at the bottom of each item, there's an option of these standards to turn track number of views on. You want to set this to yes on every single piece of content that you have in your course, okay? Now, if you've already created content, I'm gonna show you how to go in and see if you've turned this track views on, and if you haven't, how to quickly turn it on instead of having to go in and edit each one of them, okay? So this is the big key. If you wanna know what they've clicked on, have they actually clicked on an assignment? Have they clicked on a page? Have, you know, I can't really tell you if they've read it, but I can see if they've clicked on it. Okay, and it does give you within the reports whether, you know, how long they spent in it. Now, that's not going to be accurate. The student can click on something, get sidetracked, go in and answer a phone call or, you know, try to help their sibling or, you know, their friend next door that's having a problem with something and then come back. So even though we're tracking clicks, you really don't want to pay a lot of attention to how much time they spend in it, unless it's real quick. I mean, obviously, if it says that they were in there for less than a second, then you know that they're just clicking on things, okay? If they're in there for an hour, you might want to keep an eye on them and see if they're having a problem with something, okay? So the big thing is if you don't have this track number of views on, you're not going to be able to see if they've clicked on an item. Okay. Now, obviously submissions, when they submit an assignment, okay, one of the big things is, and this is something newer to Blackboard, when a student submits something, they actually hit that submit button for an assignment or mainly for the assignments, they will get an email in their T-Wolves email that will tell them that that submission has been put into Blackboard. So they will know that they've actually submitted an assignment. Okay. Obviously, when they're doing a test and they submit the test, you will get a log as to when the test was submitted. You can actually look up how long they actually were in the test. How long did it take them to do it? And you'll also be able to see in discussions if they posted something. Depending on how you have your settings set up. If you have it set up where they only have to make one post and it shows as needs grading after the one post, you'll see a yellow dot when they've submitted something. If they have submitted a post and you require three posts before needs grading, you'll see a blue dot in that section in the Grade Center. Once they've completed all of the posts that are required, then they'll see a yellow dot and you will see a yellow dot. So there's, you know, a big part of it is going to be in the Grade Center. We're going to talk about that. Okay. So accessing the course, when was the last time they accessed it? Submitting assignments, discussions, tests, whatever, and what they've clicked on in the course, as long as this track number of views is on. Okay. Now, when you go into the Grade Center and underneath the full Grade Center, you will see inside the, it looks like a little Excel spreadsheet for the students. If you see a blank spot underneath last access, that means that student never clicked on your course and went into it, okay? And then you'll see dates in here, okay? So if a student accessed the course, it will automatically put in the last date that they accessed it into the full Grade Center. Okay, so that's just a quick way of being able to go in and seeing if you have students that have never gone into your course, okay, or when they went in last. Now, this heading at the top here where it says last accessed, if you click on that, it will put them in order by the last date and group together the ones that did not come in yet. So I could quickly get this list so everybody at the top had not come in and I could have selected them at the beginning here. And then I can go down to the email feature at the bottom and email them, okay? To, you know, just send them out another notice and say, you know, you haven't gone into the course yet. Or it could be like the flag in Starfish where it's gonna go in, and if they haven't gone in 5 days, they'll get a flag through Starfish as well, all right? So that's a quick way to see if they've actually gone into your course. Okay. Now, there are also reports in Grade Center that will help you when it comes to doing census. And these reports will let you see if the students have submitted anything at any time within the start of your course. Okay. So for an example, this is a report, grade history, that I will run for a student, like let's say if they're dropped for non-attending and they're fighting it. They will contact me and ask me to run a report to find out if the student submitted any work, because an online course is only, they only have attendance if they've actually submitted something. So I can go in and run this grade history report, and that's the report that's showing up on the right here. And it will tell me, who actually submitted an assignment, when it was submitted, it gives me the date and the time. And then if I've graded the assignment, it says when I graded it, what feedback I gave them, and if there's a grade, it will put the grade in there as well. Okay, so there's a lot of information in there underneath the reports and view grade history in the full Grade Center. Okay, now, there's another report that you can run, which is this one on the left-hand side. This is the create report option underneath the reports tab in the full Grade Center. And this will be a great resource to have if you're going to meet with a student one-on-one and you want to be able to show just that student's information. So you would be able to see, it shows grades if I've graded it. It will also show something that's in progress where they've started it, but maybe have not completed it, like that test, if they saved it, but didn't submit it. You can see for this assignment 3, needs grading. That means they've submitted it, but I haven't done my work yet, and I haven't graded it yet, okay? Now, this also is what students will see if they go to My Grades in their course menu. They will basically see this exact same report on their screen, okay? But this is a way that you can run the report. So I've had to run this report when, again, to report that a student actually did complete something and, you know, something was graded by the instructor. So they did have at least one submission, so they would be considered attending in an online course, okay? So that's how you can run a couple of reports in Blackboard. And then I will show you at the end some of these reports and how to run them. Okay, I just wanted to show you some that I pulled from some of my courses. So, all right. So there's another section in your course underneath evaluation in the course menu. And it's called, the area that I'm gonna show you today is using course reports. And there's two main course reports that I use in Blackboard. One is the course activity overview, which will give you the activity of all your students in the one course based on the specific dates that you assign when you go to do this. Now, I got an example of the report on the right-hand side. And in the report at the top, it gives me a graph showing me all the hours that my students are in my course on a given day, okay? Now, one of the biggest things is, I find this very interesting, is that I have my first posts due in this particular course on Thursdays. So you can see the most activity is on Thursdays in my course. But all the remaining posts and assignments are due on Sunday. And you can see Sunday has a little bit of activity, but not a lot. So if I look at this, I might come to a couple of conclusions. I might think, okay, so hopefully Wednesday they're going in a little bit, getting started. They know that they have to understand what they're going to be posting for that Thursday post. And hopefully they're not waiting so much to the last minute. So maybe while they're in there on Thursday starting their first post, maybe they're doing some more work. So that's why they're spending more time in there on Thursdays. I have seen it kind of reverse where the day that everything is due is the highest bar. So, you know, you can kind of look at it and get a little bit of an idea. The bottom half of this report will show you each individual student and how much time they have spent in hours in the course, okay? And I've redacted the student's names here. That's why they're blacked out, but normally it would show you the name of the student on the left-hand side. And these bars in this particular report are actually active. So if I clicked on this first bar, it will actually run the second report that I'm going to show you for this student, and it will show me all the activity for that specific student. Okay, so this is another way you run the one course activity overview, but then you can drill down and find out what each one of your students have done, okay, right from this report. All right, so that brings me to the next report. Single course user participation reports. And again, I've run a report on one of my students in my current course, okay, and I have it redacted, so it's not showing the name of the student in here. So it's, again, this student, you can see, is spending more time in there on Thursday and very little time on Sunday. So if this student is actually completing their assignments, they're doing it early, which is fantastic to me. So I'm, you know, would be very happy with, you know, working with a student like this. If I saw, you know, a very little activity on Thursday and all their activity on Sunday, then I would know that they're waiting till the last minute to do all their assignments, okay? Also in this report, it's giving me the total number of hours that this student has actually been in the course. Now, again, it's going to give you an idea, but again, if the student has gone in and they've walked away while they're working on the course, it's still keeping track of that while they're in the course. So it might be a little bit exaggerated, but at least it will give me an idea. And then it also gives me an average of all my users. Now, it also gives me how many times they've logged into the course since it started, and how many, you know, items that they've clicked on, and then it tells me the last date and time that they logged in to the course, okay? Then there's a second page, and in the second page, this is where it's important for you to make sure that you turn that tracking on. This is where it's going to be a more extensive report. If you turn the tracking on for your items, and now when they click on it, it's going to let me know the last date that they actually clicked on it and the time. It's also going to tell me how many times they clicked on it. So I have what they call a landing page, which gives them access to all the parts of the course. And you can see this student has gone to that landing page 22 times. All right, but the last time they went into it was September 8th. Okay, so at this point, once they've gone in and gotten started and gotten used to the course, they might have skipped over that landing page and just gone right into the content. But I can see here that this student has gone into module 2 34 times. That might raise a little flag to me. It's like, why have they gone into that folder 34 times? You know, is there something that are having problems with? So I might reach out to the student based on this report and say, you know, were you having a problem with this? You know, why did you go into this so many times? But if you look at it, the total hours spent, they were in there for an hour and 38 minutes total for all the times that they've clicked on that assignment. Again, I take that with a grain of salt. If they've clicked on it, walked away, it's still calculating the time based on the time that it's open. Okay. That assignment itself, that's on a folder, that's an actual assignment, should have taken them about 15, 20 minutes to do. So if I look at that and I see all the times they've clicked on it and I can see how much time they spent on it, they had a problem with that. So again, I might, if they haven't reached out to me, I might reach out to them if I can see that maybe they haven't submitted the grade for that. Okay. But this is the report that you would get if you, like I said, if this first activity report, if you clicked on one of these bars, okay, and it would actually run this second report. You can skip the first one and go right into this report, and I'll show you how to run both of them in the report section of Blackboard. Okay, so it depends on whether you're looking for just the information from one person, if you want to kind of get an overview of all your students in the course. Okay, now there's also statistics reports that you can pull up on one piece of information in your course. It could be a folder, it could be an assignment, anything that they would click on, and you want to drill down on that one item. So if I just wanted to go in and see how many students and when they went into my mod two week two, and they've actually gone into that folder, I can go to the drop arrow to the right of that piece, and I can go into view statistics, and that's going to bring me to the report screen, and then I have to run the report. So when I go into the reports, I have to click the arrow pointing down to the right of this content use statistics report. And when I hit the down arrow, it will give me an option to run. So I would click on run, and then I would give it dates. And the dates that I did for this report were from the 8th to the 15th. And you can see that in the image on the right-hand side. It did basically spread it out over the month, because it automatically does 30 days for some reason. But it broke down the days that I specifically asked for on the chart on the top. I can see that the most activity was on the 9th, okay, which was last Wednesday, okay? The 10th. So I can get an idea of how many people went into that particular thing. Then what it's gonna do is it's gonna give me a listing of all the students. So this list is much longer. I just chopped out two pieces of it. So it's going to give me the name of the student, and then it will tell me how many times they actually clicked on that item on what day. So if I look at this first one on the 8th, they clicked on it 9 times. On the 9th, they clicked on it 11 times. All right. And then I can see underneath it that the next student clicked on it 0 times on the 8th, 1 time on the 9th. And then it will give you a total number of clicks for that student on that one item in your course, okay? And then at the very bottom of the report, it gives you totals. So I can tell my 25 students clicked on that, 55 times on the 8th, 84 times on the 9th, 150 something on the 10th, okay? So it just gives me an idea of, you know, when they actually were more active in that particular piece of content, whether it's a folder or a file or an item, whatever it is. Okay. All right. And this is the bottom two pages of that same report. So like I said, it tries to do like 24 days. So even though I only asked for the 8th, 9th, and 10th, it's actually giving me the 25 days in that period. How many clicks? What's the percentage of the time that they spent in there? I can see a graph for those days of the month around the dates that I looked at. So I can see that the most activity is between the 8th and the 12th, okay, or 8th and the 13th in here. And then it's giving me my percentages, how much time overall have they spent on each one of the specific days. And again, I've got a higher time on Thursday, which we saw from the original reports that we ran. Okay. So that is if you run a statistics report on one item in your course. Okay. Now, I'm going to come back to this, and I'm actually going to go into Blackboard, into the course. Okay. So this is just a practice course that I use because I can't use an actual course with students in it. So one of the first things that we talked about was using the full grade center. So if I go underneath my course management section of my menu and go into grade center and go to full grade center. Okay, so I can see the last day that somebody actually went into this course. And remember I told you that you can sort by the heading. So if I click on that, it automatically did it from oldest to newest and ones that have never gone in and accessed this course. So I can see that my test student for Lisa has never gone in here. So again, if I wanted to reach out to her, I can just select her, come down to email and email this selected user and send an email just to that student. I use the Grade Center email option all the time. I will tell you that if you select multiple students and you go in and you do the select email, even though this tells me, it will give me a listing of all the names at the top here, this is blind CC. Students will not see who this went out to. So you could kind of put a generic one in here without, you know, putting anybody's name in the message saying, oh, this is just a reminder that you haven't accessed your course yet. And put a little, you know, subject in there. Now, when I send it, I automatically tell it to include the recipients. That just goes into my email that when I get a copy of what gets sent out, and I can see who that was sent out to. Okay. All right. Now, also in here, we were talking about there's two reports that I would recommend running in here. And these are the reports that you're probably going to use for census in an online course. Okay. One of the things that I do is I always put my columns in my Grade Center in order by due date, okay? So this way, if I look at this, I can quickly look down through and see when was the last time somebody actually accessed my course, okay? So if I needed like the last access date, that also can be included in your, you put that in your report that you send to your divisions at the end of the semester as well. So you need to know when they were last in the course and active. Remember, with an online course, it's based on actual submissions. Okay. So what I want to do is I would go into reports at the top here and I would go into view grade history. Okay. And depending on the drop down at the top here, right now it's only in the last 14 days. If I wanted to drill down farther, I could go to 6 months or all. And I want to do all because, like I said, this is just a practice course and I want to see everything and then hit go. Okay, so now it went up to 3 pages of documentation. So if I scroll down at the bottom here, I can do show all. Now, if you have more than a couple pages, oh, it doesn't like it. It might tell you there's too many things and it won't show it all to you. Okay, but let's say, like I said, somebody is asking me if a student submitted anything. So what I can do is I can go to this user column and I can click on user and it will put them in alphabetic order by the name, okay? So I can actually go through this. It will group them together so I could look to see when Lisa submitted stuff. Now I have some that's Lisa preview and then I have something else. Let me see if I can get this to work. There we go. Okay, so I can go in and capture the section of the screen that talks about this user, and I could send this report to somebody. So I can see each attempt that Lisa had made, when it was, what time it was during the day, and if I graded it, I can see the grade, and if I gave any feedback, I can see the feedback that I gave the student. Okay, so I love looking at this report. This is a great way for me to see what I'm doing, what I'm missing, how students are doing, and by sorting by the user, I can group it all together and, you know, capture that particular person and what they've done, okay? I've been asked to run these reports for people in the past. Okay. Now I'm going to go back into the Grade Center. Okay. And I'm going to go in and I'm going to run that create report this time. So when I go into create report, I'm just going to put in my name, and it's for my preview student. And you can turn any of these on and it will pull in the data based on what it is, the date, the institution, so on. All right. And what I want to do down here, I only want to do it for one user. So this is what you might use if you were going to meet with that student and you wanted to run a report of all the items that they've submitted so far. So I'm going to go in and I'm going to grab, I think this is the one I want. I can tell it what information I want to show. Obviously, be careful about using username because that will show their username in the report. And obviously, you might have, you know, not that the grades showing could be a FERPA violation as well if it gets laid around. But you don't probably want to show that if you don't need to. I would show just the columns and that I have displayed on my Grade Center right now. I could do all the columns if I've hidden anything, I want to show those too. Okay. I can put in a description, I can add due dates for assignments. So if I was going to meet with that student and I wanted to show them all the due dates, I could do that. So you can turn different things on. I can put a signature in there. And when you're all done setting up the options and preview it, I can actually see this student. These are the grades I have for this student. I can see where they've started something, where it has in progress. It means they've started it, but they haven't submitted it. Needs grading means it's waiting out there for me to grade still. Okay. And then obviously anything that's blank at this point is letting them know that it's something that they still have to finish before the course is done. Okay. So that is a specific report for a specific person. Okay. They do have the option for you to go in and run that report with multiple students if you wanted to, but I usually only use it for one student at a time. Okay. So I'm just going to cancel out of that. So those two were under Grade Center, full Grade Center, and they were in the report section in here. Now the submission receipts, I never found anything in there to show up. So don't worry about that report. Okay, now one of the other reports that I had talked about, I'm gonna collapse that, was underneath the evaluation section. So if I open up evaluation, there's an option of course reports. So I can go into course reports. Okay. And the two reports that I showed in my PowerPoint, one was course activity overview, and the other one was single course user participation report. So I'm going to show you these two reports in here. All right. So course activity overview will let me go in and show the activity of all my students in this course. So you just hit the arrow at the end and hit run. Okay, and then you give it dates. So I'm gonna go back to, because like I said, this is an example course. I'm gonna go back to January 15th of 2020 until now, and then go ahead and submit this. So this one just lets you put in dates. You can't select it for a specific person. The one thing you gotta be careful of is you have a report already open. It won't open a new one. You've got to make sure you close a previous report before this one will work. Now this is taking some time because I went back to January 15th. All right, now the report came up, but it's in the background. So let me bring it in. Okay, so again, I can see this is the activity for this course, and I can see that most activity is on Tuesdays, and I can see my students. These are the bars that I was talking about and how many hours each one of these students was actually active in the course. And like I said, the bars here are active. So if I click on Jesse's bar, it's going to open that second report. Okay, gave me a hassle because let me just check and see if it's open. In the background. Okay, so there it is. So now I can see just Jesse's activity, and I can see that Jesse spent almost an hour in the course and he clicked on the learning modules 5 times, but that's all he did. Okay, So not a very useful report, but at least it will give me an idea of what Jesse has done in the course. So I'm going to go ahead and close that report. And I'm going to okay out of this report. And then I'm going to go in and I'm going to run a specific report for a specific person. Okay. So this time I'm going to run that single course user participation report. So I'm going to go to the drop arrow there and run. Okay. Why is this? This is not the right one. I'm going to have named it wrong. Let me see if this is the one instead. Student overview for a single course. Yep. Okay. So I'm going to go in and I'm going to grab my test student. And I did a bunch of stuff today, so I'm just going to go back a week on this one. So this is letting me select the specific person. And this was the student overview for a single course. And then I'm going to submit that. Okay, and it's saying no activity found. All right, so I must have picked the wrong one. Let me try a different one. All right. Like I said, because I'm working in a fake course, I might be grabbing the wrong one. Let me try a different one. Oh, it's the only one that's gone in there for me, and I know I did stuff. Okay, so let's go back. If I did Lisa now and went back to January 1st, let's see what she's done. No activity. Okay, I guess it's going to have to be Jesse all the way. So let me go back in and run a new report. We'll do Jesse again from January. And I'll get the same report that I did when I clicked on the bar for him. Okay, so there's all the information. Obviously, if I grabbed a student that was clicking on a lot of things, I would get a whole list of all the things that they clicked on in that report. Okay, and you'll notice this bar is yellow, so it's not an active bar. So I can't click on it and drill down to see what he did on the Tuesday in that course. Okay, so that's the report. Okay, and the last thing that I talked about was going in and pulling in a report for a specific item. So one of the things we had talked about is making sure that you have tracking on. I went into my learning module content area. I can see that these items here that the tracking is on, it's telling me that it's enabled. But if I look at this folder for tests and quizzes, that means I'm not tracking if anybody clicks on that. So if I go to the drop arrow here, there's an option to turn statistics tracking on and off. Now I can turn that on and submit it. And now I will see the tracking. Now, the problem with this is it's not going to go back and see what students have clicked on that previous to you turning this on. So that's why it's very important to make sure that it's turned on right away as soon as you create the items. Okay. Now, if I go in, I can check to see who clicked on this specific item. So if I go into the drop arrow here, and there's an option of view statistics reports. Okay, comes to reports, it pulls up the report that I want to use, and I can click on this and run it. Okay, now this is one report that I can run it for everybody or individual students. I'm going to do the January date in here, okay, to now, and I'm going to select everybody. So if I click on one, it selects the one, but see how as soon as I click on somebody else, it turns the first one off. But what I can do is click on the first one, scroll to the bottom of my list, and if I hold down my shift key and click, it selects everybody in between, okay? So everybody is going to be included in this report. If I wanted just a few people and they're not next to each other, I can click on one, hold down my control key, and click on each additional person that I want in the report. You can see now it's only selecting individual people. All right, so shift selects everybody in between the first and the last one that you select, and the control will let you select individual people. Okay. Now this report will actually let you see if somebody is no longer in the course. So it's a nice report. So I've got, it's going to do it as a PDF. I can export out to Word, Excel, or an HTML file. I just do a PDF and then hit submit. Okay, so this report is mainly for clicks, okay? So it's gonna be broken down by the person. It's gonna let you know if they've clicked on it, what day, because it has the dates across the top. This is gonna be a very long one because I did 6 months worth of dates, okay? At the bottom, it's gonna give me an idea within an 18-day period or whatever, 24-day period, what days they were actually in there, how many hours they were in there based on the day, okay? And then at the bottom, it's gonna give me statistics as to what day is the most active in for this item in the course, okay? The big thing is, did they click on it? That's all it's really gonna tell me in here. So I could check to see if Lisa ever clicked on that item, which they didn't, okay? So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna close out of that report. Okay, and you can run these individual reports by going into evaluation, course reports, and there's some different ones in here. I can even look to see, you know, how active has the student been in a form? If you have groups, how active have they been in the groups? Maybe a group discussion, things like that. It all depends on what you're having your students do in your course. But the two that I use the most are this course activity overview and the student overview for a single course. Okay. All right. So now, all right. So at this point, I've showed you how to go in and run all the different reports. All right. So any faculty can run the reports that I showed you. As a system admin, I also have the ability to go in and check to see how often a specific student is actually logged in to Blackboard, okay? And I can see if they have tried a username and password that are not correct, it will let me know. And it will let me know whether they've used their, what they call the system LDAP login or not, okay? So if you need any help with any of these reports or any other questions about Blackboard, you can call the Open SUNY Help Desk or submit a ticket. I put in their new extended hours in here. They are open 5 days a week, 7 a.m. to 12 midnight. And then they have from 10 a.m. to 8 or 9 o'clock on Saturday and Sunday. And you and your students can call them for help. So it's very important to make sure that you give them that phone number so that they can go in and do it, and or you can give them the URL to go in and submit a help ticket as well. Also, you can contact the online learning department and ask any questions that you have. Okay, so at this point, I'm done with my presentation. So if you would like to ask any questions, you can unmute yourself and I can go back over anything or, you know, just let me know if you have any questions. I see that I still have Dan and Melissa on. Okay.
Oh, I'm good. Thank you very much.
Okay. All right. Melissa, do you have any questions?
Okay. I do not on this seminar, no.
Okay. So I'm going to stop the recording. Okay.